welcome to Intro to St. Louis Shag, Week 3, April 2018. This is PJ Ryan.
This is Joy Jing.
So today we reviewed crosses, which looked like this.
Yep, so we reviewed inside crosses.
Cross and run. Yeah?
So notice that adds two counts to our normal pattern. So
and we prep on an outside mm-hmm. run.
We also talked about this arm connecting here instead of our normal connection here. This helps us prep on the spot and rotationally.
Yeah, we talked about follows keeping their elbow down and kind of engaging with the shoulder mm-hmm. blades to get that pop.
Yep, and leaders connecting around our follower's shoulder blade. So that prep looks like this. Prep and run, run, cross. Cross and prep and run, run, cross. We also talked about
tuck turns.
Looks like this.
Shoot, ba-da-ha. Shoot, ba-da-ha. Ooh, shoot, ba-da-ha.
One more.
Shoot, ba-da-ha. Shoot, ba-da-ha. Shoot, ba-da.
Yep. Yeah, we talked about that prep.
So the prep is on an outside kick.
Yep. Leaders, we moved our hand from our follower's back to their hip.
And twist in. And so because I'm being prepped, I release my left hand because I don't need it. Mm-hmm. And this helps on the release. Shoot, ba-da. Ha.
Yep.
We gave followers an exercise. So if PJ is just standing there, to practice the solo against a wall, I can do triple and prep, turn, triple and troop, shoot, ba-da, hoop, ba, shoot, ba-da, ha. Yeah? Yep. And I'm kind of trying to hook around that leg so that I do the majority of this turn on the kick step so that I land my triple almost all the way rotated.
Yep. And leaders, we also talked about the rowing this hand towards our follower's opposite hip to help with that turn. So once again, triple and prep and triple and 7-8, triple and kick.
Yeah, yep. We also talked about follows following through all the way, but because I allow this left arm to drop down, I'm allowing PJ to catch me using my left arm mm-hmm. Rather than trying to target an ending spot.
Yep, and then we talked about inside turns or pop turns. So the way this works is we have that same connection here with our follower's back, follower's connecting to the leader's arm in the same way as when we did these crosses, and we just do a pop turn, and this is on an inside kick. So it looks like this. Triple step, turn, triple and three, four, triple and kick. And the whole of the prep and the release happens a little bit quicker than that outside tuck turn.
Yeah, and we talked about how in St. Louis Shag, there's a lot more responsibility on the follow to kind of ride into the lead's prep and use him use my lead to rotate myself around, yeah? So I'm not kind of relying on PJ to push mm-hmm. me. We also demoed repeated turns, yep. which look like this.
So we can link them together. The prep for the catch of one becomes the prep of the other.
Shoot, ba-da-ha. Shoot, ba-da-ha. Shoot, ba-da-ha.
These can be done on the spot, sharing the distance equally between each turn, or with the leader rotating clockwise around the follower, just to shorten the length of that pop turns.
Yeah, and we talked about how it's pretty clutch to keep the turning on the spot and not travel too much.
Yep, that was it. Thank you so much, and we'll see you next week.